So good evening, everybody. We're going to start because we're live streaming. So one of the pieces that we're going to start with is one that calls us to sing into the quiet, into the prayer. It was arranged by Chris, so we're going to sing that into the quiet. So everybody has a program, so you can join with us. Okay, Chris. Chris, do a lovely job in that. Chris. So, I'm going to sing a piece that I wrote in Gaelic first. This, and I translated then into English. So, I'm going to sing the verse in Gaelic for you. We sang it during the Mass this evening. But it's called Evermore, I'll Sing Your Praise. And when I wrote this, it was interesting that a guy took it away, and I didn't know it. He brought it back to Norway, and he gave it to a group there of young boys. They were a boy band. And so they were singing in Irish, a spiritual song, which they didn't know anything about. And it got to number two in Norway. But they were singing this song, and this is it here. Program as well. Evermore I'll sing your praise, evermore through endless days, God of all seasons, bright and reason, God of love and endless grace. I got more gross, more here, more God, Molya Magrahagya Mahiana Magrama Kris Magrama Kri Magraya Fatu Ari Magloida. The next song we're going to sing is one that has been very kind to me, but one that you can sing with us. It's called The Cloud's Veil. We sang it tonight at the start of the Mass for the prologue. But I wrote this song for an uncle of mine who was my music mentor, and he was killed tragically in a car accident. And I wrote it and I used it, and the day after 9/11 happened, I was going back to Limerick where I was studying at the time, I was studying music, and GIA called me and they asked me if they could use it for the memorial service for 9/11. So they had got three songs. One was, Amazing Grace. One was, forget what it was, and the third one was The Cloud's Veil. And the reason they wanted to use it was because the images used on the television were countless clouds of dust, and the cloud was veiled from the sky. This was sent to me by a woman who wrote. She wrote it on a scrap of paper, and it was an old prayer that she found in Kerry. And it said that when the sun is veiled in the sky, remember I am still present. And that was the catalyst for which I wrote the song. So GIA used the song, and it was downloaded. They asked me would I download it, and I gave it freely. And it was downloaded many, many times, many thousands of times, by the people of 9/11. So here it is for you, The Cloud's Veil. You can join them with it.
God is by my side.
Light the stars at night that mirror heaven's way to you. Bright the stars in life where dwell the saints in love and truth.
And though the rain hides the stars,
couple at home were getting married in Ireland, and I was asked to write a song for them. And so I went to the book of Psalms where it's written, the Psalm of Psalms, where I found the text for this song. So to sing it for us, would you put your hands together for Anna Betancourt? Who's going to sing it for us? You can
take sure. It off. Thank you.
Live to be holy, live as if only someone is calling you deep in your heart. Live to be holy, humble and lowly. Love will find you and dwell in your heart. Where is the place that you go? With a
So one night I was, after coming home in Ireland, it was about 3 o'clock in the morning from a gig, and I was really tired, and I just wanted to die in the armchair. You know the way you feel. I didn't want any calls. I didn't want anyone to talk to me. I just wanted to sleep in the armchair and probably wake up at 4 o'clock and not know where I was. But anyway, I woke up suddenly and I found myself that I didn't think I was alone. And I found myself in the presence of my guardian angel who I'd forgotten about. And I immediately started writing, and these are the words that came out of a song called The Voice of an Angel. So here to sing it is the voice of an angel, Meredith. Sorry, should I say that Kristen is going to dance this as well, so give her a good round of applause.
When I'm lying in the darkness and I'm half afraid to sleep, I keep thinking of tomorrow and the thoughts that lie so deep. Then I pray and talk in whispers, 'cause I know that somewhere near the presence of an angel come to hold me through my fear. And who are you who guides me, my messenger of light? Will you walk beside me now? The voice of an angel, the voice
Thank you, Kristen. Liam Lawton.
Didn't they do a good job? Thank you, Christian, for dancing. And thank you, Meredith, for singing. So, this piece we sang it during the Mass. It's called Ubi Caritas, where charity and love are, there is God. So we all came through the pandemic and COVID, and it was really bad at home as well. I lost my dad during the COVID, and we couldn't get in to see him in the hospital even. He died without any of us. So I saw a lot of good people sharing their kindness and their compassion and their love and their support. And so it got me to write a piece. This is from the new collection that I've done, which is from GAA. It's called Come and Listen. And it's called Ubi Caritas. And it's where charity and love are, there is God. Because I saw a lot of charity and a lot of love during the COVID time.
Thank you.
This next piece is from the same collection as well. It's actually 3 years since I sang, so it's good that we're back together again. But this piece I wrote is called You Are Not Alone. I wrote it during the pandemic for a lockdown for a friend of mine whose father was dying in a hospital. She wasn't allowed in, so she sat in the car park for 3 hours waiting for her father to pass. And he did. And so I wrote this song for her. It's called You Are Not Alone. It's for the father. Let's hear it for the dancers. The next piece is taken from this new collection as well. It's a psalm. It's to you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. So you can join with us. Thank you. So, in the orchestra and hiding behind the back is Dennis Doyle. Dennis, as you know, plays the harp. He's going to come out here and play a lovely tune called Eleanor Plunkett. Give him a round of applause. So, Dennis is going to play a piece by Carlin. He was a blind poet and a player who lived in the Middle Ages, in the medieval times in Ireland, and he wrote many, many harp tunes. And this one is called Eleanor Plunkett. Dennis is going to play. Thank you. do well. I think he deserves another clap. Give him a clap there. So, a few years ago, I wrote a collection called Healing Song, and they were all songs of healing. And one of the things that I was interested in was healing in the church. And so I wrote one of the pieces called Heal Us, Lord, and we're going to sing that for you now. So please join in with us in the refrain. And if you know anybody that needs healing tonight, if they're not here, think about them and pray for them as well. We'll send them all our love and our healing energy as well. Since I was at Congress last, it was about 3 years ago, I have become a pastor, and I have, on average, 3 funerals a week. And I always use the passage, because I think it's a beautiful passage, "There are many rooms in my Father's house." Little did I think when I was writing this song that I'd be using this passage. But here we are, "There are many rooms in my Father's house." Please sing it with us.
There are many rooms in my Father's house. Do not be afraid and have no doubt. I am going there to preach.
Thank you. At home in Ireland, in a church in Dublin, is the body of Blessed Charles of Mount Argus. And he died in the 19th century. And it was 100 years since he had died, and I was asked to write a song about him. But he was born in England, and he went to work with those. I know that here in America, many people came on the boats after the famine. But many people also went to England who couldn't afford to go to America. And they lived and worked, they lived in Manchester, in the big cities, in London. And Blessed Charles went and lived among these people in London. And they were the poorest of the poor. He learned to speak their language, and he followed them over to Dublin when they came back. Some of them came back. And he was there, and he was a marvelous confessor, apparently. People used to come from miles around to hear his, for them to make a confession to him. So I wrote a piece called Come to Me, which is about him and is about his philosophy in life. I'm going to sing it now for you.
All right.
So we're getting near towards the end of the concert, but this is a song called Come and Listen, and I wanted to write a sacred text to this song. It's based on a traditional song called The Garden Mother's Lullaby, and it was written around the medieval times. In this, if you really want to hear this song well, the UCD scholars have a beautiful version of The Garden Mother's Lullaby in four parts. But this is, Garden was the place St. Colum Kill came from as well. And it's up in Donegal, up in the north of Ireland. It's a beautiful, beautiful place. So it's Come and Listen. And in the second verse, the girls will sing it, listen to, I've mentioned the word child, because I've tried to link it to the lullaby. And the song is apt today.
Glorify the Lord with me, together praise his name. Glorify the Lord with me, forever and the same. All peoples now revere the Lord, and lift your heads on high, and look to him and be radiant, for God will hear your cry.
Child, oh, come and fear the Lord. Come and listen well, my child, and hear his holy word. The Lord is close to all who call aloud his name. Oh, taste and see the Lord is good, from age to age the same.
Bless the Lord all times, his praise shall set me free. I will bless the Lord all times, and all my fears shall flee. In the Lord my soul shall make its boast, let the humble hear and be glad. The Lord is close to all who call, to all hearts that are sad.
Be glad to know that we've come to the last song, and it's called Sing Forever. And somebody in the choir said today, we've been singing forever, because let's hear it for the musicians and the singers, because they sang for the mass as well and played for the mass as well. So, I hope you enjoyed this time together with us. And we're going to leave you with this piece called Sing Forever. It's from the Healing Song Collection. And it's, well, we'll hear you sing. His name is blessed. People are filled with wonder. Songs of praise ascend. We have heard God's lasting promise. Love will never end. Sing. As well. Thank you, Janelle. And for the dancers, and Christian. And for all my singers, and Fran and Meredith, who did the solos. And for the musicians as well, and Chris. Thank you, and safe home. God bless you all.